Fusilarlos. Eso.
La gente está muy apática. Yo creo que hasta que no te pasa, andas luchando. Diario subimos personas desaparecidas, 2, 3 personas desaparecidas. Hay veces que la gente no sabe, pero se sigue desapareciendo gente en Mexicali. Prácticamente a veces subimos hasta 4 desaparecidos diarios.
Percent contained after burning nearly 114,000 acres since it started almost 3 weeks ago. Crews are fighting fire with fire to contain the stubborn blaze. You can see fire dropping helicopters setting backfires to get rid of fuel and protect homes.
Iran is ready to extend its hands and cooperate with others in the international community to bring back multilateralism and diplomacy at the center of the international relations and save the remnants of this architecture, which is unfortunately getting disbanded piece by piece. To this end, there is no way but to get united and put an end to the destructive behavior of the United States administration for the interests of all of us.
Peaceful uses of nuclear technology would benefit.
On top of its horrific record as the world's largest state sponsor of terrorism, Iran has a lamentable history of providing only grudging, dilatory, and incomplete cooperation, if at all, with the IAEA. Iran must do more, much more, to ensure both timely and complete compliance with the safeguards obligations.
All right.
También en México, un niño con trastorno genético en los huesos le pidió públicamente ayuda al líder del cártel Jalisco Nueva Generación tras la falta de apoyo del gobierno. El pequeño grabó un video dirigido al Mencho pidiéndole dinero para someterse a una cirugía que necesita urgentemente, ya que este trastorno hace que sus huesitos se quiebren fácilmente como si fueran de vidrio. Escuche su súplica.
This was the third night local demonstrators took to the streets, speaking out against the decision to not charge police officers in Taylor's death. Tonight we saw protesters blocking intersections and deputies on guard in full riot gear. Now, just over an hour ago, deputies fired a few flashbangs and the protesters scattered. Deputies say they have made 10 arrests.
Violence on the Las Vegas Strip. Another fight ending in gunfire near the Paris.
A fight between two groups ended in shots fired. Police showed up near the Paris Hotel around 2 in the morning. A man and a woman were taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. This is far from the first fight we've seen since casinos reopened.
At least 3 large fights on the Las Vegas Strip have been caught on camera since Labor Day weekend.
Both inside and outside different strip hotels. Las Vegas Metro Police even announced recently that they won't tolerate them any longer. Of the visitors we spoke to, one thing they did see is a large police presence.
We haven't noticed any fights or anything. We just see like kind of cop cars at night, but that's pretty much it.
If this type of fights are affecting the numbers of tourists here in our city, that's something that is still unknown. According to the Las Vegas Convention Center, those numbers may show up in the following month.
The city of Las Vegas has appointed a new city manager. Jorge Cervantes will be ratified at the city council meeting on October 7th. He's been with the city since 1998 and most recently serving as a chief operations and development officer. Cervantes has also worked as the executive director of community development and the director of public works.